Yeah. so below, as above, so below, as above, so below, as above, so below, as above, so below.
So below, as above, so below.
These days we've been trained to see one of each of these dichotomies as pain, its opposite as pleasure. To take both together, to stow away whatever ultimately ineffectual umbrella it is that you're protecting yourself with, unrealizingly dividing, is to invite communion with something vitally more than human. To become a sometime lover of the capriciously passionate pan. Try as you might in the midst of this numinous, yet still, nevertheless, less than consensual union, just a casual mindfuck for puck, you can't help but be swept back in time and wide-eyed find yourself fleetingly identified with the first self-conscious troglodyte. She went outside to pee, awoken from dreams after orgy caused by psychedelic spores, foraged earlier that day from atop the turds of ungulate herds. Now she stares upwards at a night of stars in wonder. What am I? What are they? What are we blundering towards in our technologic only, separating society, when all joy with any deeper meaning is really the feeling of being a part of, belonging within, a mind-bogglingly large work of art, each a song theme in the universe symphony. Could it be that all we need to do to reconnect with first ecstasy in the streets of the cities is to remove our shoes or refuse the ceaseless food supply sometimes, thereby stepping into recognition of ancient monkey situation, casting off conditioning, embracing the traditional pain of being an animal hanging on by teeth's skin, seeing clearly that we're suspended mid-air from anything, from everything, for which we care by a thin string, the weight-bearing ability of which is a constantly keening uncertainty. Be at ease with your difficulties, body's aches, and nature's unpredictabilities, which includes other people's vagaries too. Not for a religion's theoretical cosmology reasons that are often really another means of self-protection, but from an experientially rational practicality that states that seeking comfort alone is the path away from the deepest connectedness it's possible for a lowly primate to know. So miss a meal, be too hot or cool, forgive a foolish imposition, feel love refusing to meet fruition, underrate precipitation, take on the seemingly impossible mission, forbear the barely bearable. For perhaps it's fair to say, my fellow apes, that in fact the way to hell is paved with metaphorical umbrellas raised. Thank you.
Thank you.
Again to glean its trajectory. But with time and age come rain, and we learn to savor the bliss, hold it in our mouths and swish it round, and even spit it out, lest drunkenness and lack of recollection cloud our judgment. The memory of the flavor of that grape alone sustains. And we grow other senses that let us know in which direction lies the vineyard. And, like a miracle, we find it. And let the soft earth take us.
Thank you.
Andy Bevan. And tenor saxophone, Kojun Sato. And accordion, Kevin McHugh. Hiroki Togashi on drums. And Huw Lloyd on contrabass and clarinet.